Hi, I'm Matas, a creative from Sweden. Today we're checking out a new software calibration system from Sonarworks called Sound ID Reference Generation 4. Now, to be honest, I've been very skeptical about these kinds of softwares in the past, but maybe Sonarworks can prove me wrong. Today we're here in my new studio setup, and it's only been partly acoustically treated, so it's a really great time to try out something like the Sound ID Reference to see if we can get a more flat frequency response from the speakers. Now, I personally make most of my mixes with headphones. Why? Because it's much easier to mix the low frequency range if you have headphones. But to get your mixes right, you need to listen back to your music on different sound systems and on different speakers. And that's where this Sound ID reference comes into play. So let's do a little bit of sound calibration here and see if we can improve the monitoring system in my studio. Let's take the tour.
Men, akta bara sladda.
Quick disclaimer, I did receive the Sound ID reference package and microphone from Sonarworks. That said, they have no influence over what I say or what I do in this video. Right, so first out, you need to go and purchase the software or download a free trial software. There's a 21-day free trial that you can try out. And while installing the Sonarworks software, you will notice that there's two specific apps. You have one like native app for processing your desktop audio. And you also have the Sound ID reference plugin, which you can run within your DAW. So the next step is to create our profile. So we go in here and press new speaker measurement. And I'm using the Sound ID reference microphone to do the measurements. But you can also use your own shotgun microphone for running the calibration. So next up, you're setting up your listening position, your listening spot.
Please adjust the volume of your output device. My voice should sound at normal conversation volume. Left speaker. Right speaker.
Nice. Okay, the calibration takes you about 20 minutes, but no worries, we're just gonna see a fraction of the process. Basically, you move around the microphone while the Sound ID app does its thing with the sine sweeps. So what's a sine sweep? A sine sweep is a sine wave played at an increasingly higher pitch, from a very low to high pitch. It's a quite fast sweep through the frequency spectrum. It was a bit tricky to move the microphone to the correct place, so I can advise you to also move the microphone up and down slightly to find the sweet spots. Okay, so we're finally finished with that sound calibration, but as you know, there are no shortcuts to the perfect sound. Anyways, after the sound calibration, Sound ID reference presents us with a frequency response curve that's measured at our listening position. So by looking at the measured curve here from my room, we can see that there's a bunch of different problems. We have problems below 100 Hz. It's dropping quite drastically here. We also have some problems around 200 Hz and also at around 1 kHz. So there's a bunch of different problematic areas here in this room. And now, the magical moment we all waited for, let's activate the Sound ID reference calibration and see how it affects the frequency curve. So here we can see that the Sound ID reference found some way of compensating these problematic areas so that we will get a more flat frequency response. So let's open up Spotify and play back some of my tracks from Gellhain.
Meant for us to fly.
Right, so you're obviously not going to hear the difference here when I deactivate and activate the calibration service, but I can definitely hear that Sound ID fills out that lower region and the 200 Hz area and also that 1 kHz area. When I disable the calibration software, it instantly sounds like there's like holes in the frequency spectrum. So to my ears, it's much more closer to listening to this track on headphones compared to when I listen to the speakers in this room. So, Soundworks and Sound ID Reference is definitely a winner in my ears. Now, if you want to try this yourself, you can go and download the free trial and let me know in the comments what you think about the results from your studio. Now, if you're going to buy Sound ID Reference, I highly recommend that you use any of my affiliate links in the description. That way you also support my work here on YouTube, so I can make more awesome videos for you. Right, thanks for watching today, hope you had a nice time, and now you can continue and watch my next video. See you in the next one, my name is Matthias, bye.